It's been a very long 15 months for many of us, unable to hug a loved one during the pandemic. But imagine what it's like not to feel the embrace of family members for other reasons. Well, that's the reality for some members of the LGBTQ community. Reporter Julio Avila shows us one group that's stepping forward to help.
You want to cry, you want to hug them tighter, you want to say, come home with me, I'll be your mom.
Cindy Marshall is with Free Mom Hugs, a national organization that gives out hugs and support to those identifying as LGBTQ and who may have been rejected by their parents. She and her fellow moms were at the Pride and the Vibe Festival on Sunday, hugging away.
I had one young trans woman tell me that she had had her therapist help her come out to her parents just the day before. And they completely rejected her.
But what kind of impact does a hug provide?
We know that the neurotransmitters having to do with the chemical oxytocin, which is the feel-good chemical, gets released whenever people hug.
Gary Rotfuss is a clinical social worker who says physical contact is part of who humans are. He used the pandemic as an example where physical contact was lacking, a painful reality for many members of the LGBTQ community.
To be rejected by that family or anyone in that family has profound, long-lasting impact emotionally.
A report from the American Psychological Association found those rejected by their parents are almost 9 times more likely to commit suicide, 6 times more likely to feel depressed, and are 3 times more likely to use illegal drugs. But even after rejection, can that bond be rebuilt?
Yes, it's possible to try to start a dialogue between parent and child to heal that, but it does have to start with an acceptance and an understanding of our parents' part.
And as parents, we are given this beautiful gift to love. And if you can't love that beautiful gift, then you don't deserve that beautiful gift.